Welcome to a new test and teardown video. This time it's a Huntron tracker, model HTR1005 B-1S. So this one is the S version, and I think that is the double input. And then there's a switch where you can select between the two inputs. So you can compare different components and see what is going on. It looks like, actually, if you look at this carefully here, it looks like it's a little bit of a home modification, but that is how they look. So they just figured out this was an upgrade, or this was how they wanted it to be, and then they didn't make a new front plastic layout. So that's just how it is. So that, I think this is how you select between the two inputs. So what is it this tracker is doing? This is actually a component sweeper, and it sweep voltage and current on the two axes. And you select the test voltage range by hitting low, medium, or high. So low is 20 volts. Medium is 40 volts and high is 120 volts. And of course they got different current settings as well, but it's low current, so you can put in a zener diode, transistors, regulators, capacitors, inductors, whatever you want to test, and then you'll be able to see the voltage and current sweep. It is a 80 hertz a sine wave sweep, so you just go backwards and forward like that, and it's just a resistor bridge that goes to a little CRT scope. So it's a very, very simple product. You can't change the frequency or anything like that. You can just adjust vertical and horizontal here, and if the picture is too big or too small, all you have to do is change the different test voltage ranges. As you see here, there's a problem with the switches. So when you need to push one of the switches in, you have to push down and then click it in. So I guess there is a screw missing inside. See, there's a loose PCB in here. Maybe it was dropped on the floor. I really hope this works, because I got some high voltage zener diodes I would love to see if they work. We also got correct voltage per division here and all that kind of stuff. It's actually a very, very useful product. There isn't a lot more to say about this unit, really. There's no other switches or adjustments or anything like that. Only the type number label like that. That's all there is to it. So how about we just plug it in and see if it works? I think that is what we want to do, right? So I turned the instrument on. Let's just crank on mains and see what happens. 16 watts. Let me turn down the light a little bit here. Probably brightness here is... Yeah, look at that. So there's a line. So this is how we select. All right. So now there's no signal. This is a 12 volt zener diode. Look at that. So let's try and reverse it. If I short it, I got no voltage but a lot of current. And then the other way. Now, what do you know? So if that is what I think it is, we don't see the breakdown, right? This got to be the low voltage part of it, right? See, if I short it, here is zero. Zero is now in the middle, right? See? So why don't I see that? That is because I am in low. So let's go to medium. medium is here. Oops, so there is a resistor broken because it's supposed to be a flat line like that, right? Now it's only voltage and only current. Okay, now it works. Medium works. And then, haha, perfect. Now we see the voltage and then we see the breakdown. We're gonna go and zero that one. Have it exactly in the middle. So now I know where 0 volts is, right? See? So this is the forward of a zener diode and this is the reverse part. How cool is this instrument? This is definitely super, super useful. I love it already. Look at that. Ha, ha, manna. We can use this for a lot of cool things. And yes, I was right about the different inputs. See, this is the yellow input. And if I move the red wire to the red, like that, see, nothing happens. Switch up. Oh yes, in the middle, it's gonna switch back buttons forward. Oh, how cool is that? And this is exactly what they mean. In the manual, they show you that you can probe two boards side by side, a good one and a broken one. And all you have to do is connect the ground to the ground of all the boards, of course. And then you just probe each of the two test signals here at the same point on each of the board. And then you're going to get the same curve. And then you just probe. Just like being extremely dumb and I don't know what, like that, right? And then suddenly you're going to find a curve that is not the same on the two boards. And then you found the area on that board where there's a difference. And then you can see deeper into that area. So this is like repairing electronics for people that with no electronic background at all. But I mean, this unit can really do that. And this is what they show in the manual, how you can probe around like that. It's so, so funny. So that is the auto switch mode between forward and or the two inputs. I love it. Cool idea. But I really want to open it and see if I can find the fault with the low setting. And since we got the two other inputs working, that is great. How about this high? This is 120 volts, by the way. So let me switch it to the other one. Let's try and find a neon bulb. That was disappointment. I found a lot of different neon bulbs, and not a single one was able to light up at 120 volts. That's a little bit disappointing. It could have been real cool to show the curve of a neon bulb going on and off. It's actually quite interesting, but that just didn't work out. I guess we need a little bit more voltage for that to happen. Ew. So I guess we need to open this. Oh, did I mention this unit only uses 11 watts? So I guess nothing gets warm or anything like that. So how do we open this thing? Aha. It's probably easier. I don't know exactly what to say about this, but after I removed the four screws, it was actually quite difficult to figure this out because all the plastic kind of grab into the grooves here and kind of locks as well. So to be able to pull this out, it's gotta be done exactly straight. So it's almost impossible to open it. But okay. At least we are in. Whoa. That is interesting. We got a few transformers. Oh, we also got a high voltage switch mode over here in the back. That's probably for the CRT, obviously, right? And then, is that a connector? So we can take away the front panel or something like that. And why is this not doing its thing here. Uh-huh. We got some screws in here. So the PCB should have been screwed in place. And all those screws are missing. Look at that. So that is the problem. That is why we're having these problems here, right? So yes, definitely. That is some missing screws. But luckily I got a schematic from a radio museum. So now I will find the schematic and then I will see what is so special about the low, medium, high settings. Got some differences in the output voltage, but we also got some differences in the bridge components. And where exactly are they located? Yeah, look at that. Also here, there's a missing screw. Definitely something I need to fix. I was able to find a schematic both on Radio Museum and also on the Huntron web page. Let's first look a little bit on the inside here. And then you'll see there is a switch mode power supply for the high voltage parts of the CRT. Here's the mains transformer. This is the output transformer that's driving the test circuit. And this is the output, the oscillator and the output stage via the transformer and all that kind of stuff. And if we look at the schematic from a radio museum, you can see it is not looking like this product. The high voltage is made in a completely different way, and some blocks are more or less missing from that schematic. And if we look at the schematic from the Huntron web page, we'll see the missing blocks there are actually here, but it is again more or less the same schematic as the one from Radio Museum, but the high voltage is made and again not like the one I got here. So we got different versions of this product. Also, remember when I was testing this unit, I was complaining about in the low current and low voltage, low voltage, high current, obviously, in the low range, we had this line that was not flat, remember? And I was complaining about, oh, this got to be a fault. But look, I also found a full manual on the Huntron webpage. And in that manual, it explains the different open circuit pictures in the different modes of test voltage. And in the low voltage, yes, the line is not straight. So that is a known, just bad design kind of fault, if you ask me. Because, of course, it should be completely vertical and completely horizontal, depending if it's voltage or current, if it's open or if it's shorted. This is how I would have done it if, you know, if I was supposed to do a product like this. But this is just the way it is. So, yes, there is no errors. There is nothing wrong with this unit other than the missing screws. So I'm just going to put in the missing screws here and call it a day. I was also trying to figure out if I push this down and if I push down the PCB here, the buttons aren't really perfectly aligned. There isn't really... Yeah, okay, it kind of works, but it's not perfect. So I better fix that. So yes, that is what I wanted to say about this absolutely fantastic unit. It's actually really, really useful.